Welcome to Naresh High Technologies. This is Ramchandar. In this video, I'm going to talk about one very important point related to multi-threading, that is our program executing by threads or not? Our concept is our Java program executing by threads or not? See, whatever the statements which we have in our program, each and every statement executing by JVM with the support of thread. With the support of which thread? That thread name is main thread. One more time I'm repeating. Each and every Java program executing by the JVM with the support of one thread, that thread name is main. So how can we prove? Our concept is our program executing by threads or not? Then how can we prove that? Observe. To understand this point, we should have knowledge on two methods. Initially, we must and should be understand one method. What is that? Current thread. This is basically static method. This is static method of java.lang.thread class. What it will giving? It will gives thread object name. Thread object name means the thread which is executing that current statement, that thread name will giving, that thread object will giving. So static method means, how can we call that method? Very simple, class name dot current thread. Now observe, what is the use of the current thread method here? The thread which is useful for executing that current statement, that thread object will giving. Now, observe here. Let me take one notepad, or let me take Eclipse. Already I opened. Now, in the Eclipse, I written one program like a test. In this test class, I'm writing one static block, system.out.println static block. Here I am writing like thread dot current thread. Now here I am taking one non-static block. Here I am writing like system.out.println non-static block. Here I am writing again thread dot current thread. Now in the same manner I am taking some variable. What is that? Static int a equal to m1 method, static int m1 method. Here I'm writing like system.out.println m1 method. Here I'm writing like thread dot current thread. Now in the same manner I'm taking one variable int b equal to m2, non-static variable. This is what your m2 method. Non-static methods must and should be ended with the return statement. Here int m2. Here I'm writing like a system.out.println thread dot current thread. Let me take constructor. Let me take one constructor. System.out.println. 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 Thread dot current thread. See, here I'm taking static block, non-static block, constructor, non-static block, static block and static variable and static method and non-static variable and non-static method, okay? And I'm taking one constructor also. Now here, whenever we load this program, static data is going to loading first. So static loading phase and initialization will executing. Static loading phase and initialization phase. What I'm writing, run as Java application. Now run as Java application, who will executing the static block? One thread. And M1 executing by the one thread. Now, what is this representation? So I will go for representation, wait for 1 minute. In the meanwhile, I want to execute entire program. Test t equal to new test, and here I'm writing like system.out.println main. Here I'm writing like thread.currentThread. Now let me run this program. If you are clearly observe, who will executing static block? One thread. And who will executing M1 method? One thread. Who will executing the main method? Thread. Who will executing non-static block? Thread. Non-static method? Thread. Constructor? Thread only. So, each and every statement of our application is always executing by the thread only. Then what is this representation? What is this representation? Very simple, we are printing a reference. Thread.currentThread will giving what your object. That object I am directly printing. If you are printing object, internally println method always calling what? ToString method. Internally println method always calling what your? ToString method. If it is object class ToString method, it will showing output like package name dot class name at the rate package name dot class name at the rate memory in hexadecimal format. But already ToString method is overridden in the thread class. Let me open command prompt and here I'm checking java.lang.thread. Now clearly observe, there is a method, ToString method. This ToString method already overridden in the thread class by Java community people. So what is this ToString method will do? This ToString method will print output like this. What is this? Thread, letter, thread name, comma, thread priority, comma, thread group name. Okay, now what is the first word? For example, let me take our output. Thread, first word main, 5, second word also main, third word. Now what is the first word meaning? It is just a representation of, thread. Whether this object is belongs to thread or not, that representation purpose, they are taking first what here? Thread name. After that, which thread is going to executing? Main thread. What is the priority of that main thread? 5. And what is this thread group name? This is thread group name. So every thread is a part of what here? One thread group. So we have a system is one main thread group. Under that we have one more thread group, that is what? Main. Under the main we have a different threads, user defined thread or one more thread like what here? Main. Now under the system thread we have, individual threads also. One is finalizer, another one is reference handler, signal dispatcher, attach listener, like this lot of threads we have. System is one main thread group. Under that what we have? One more thread group like main. This is the main thread group name. What about this main? This is a thread name. This is what? Thread name. this is the thread name, okay, and this is what here, priority of a thread, and this is what thread group name. So thread is the, see, if you take a wording like main, wording like main, main is a what? Method. Main is a thread name, and also main is thread group name. Thread group name. Clear or not? So main we can use in three formats. One is method, another one is thread name, another one is thread group name. So if you cleanly observe this output, if you cleanly observe this output, we can understand each and everything will be executing by whom? Thread only. So threads internally using by whom? JVM. JVM uses one thread. JVM uses one thread. What is that? Thread name, main thread, and executing what here? Entire program. Clear or not? So this is the proof we can say whether the our program is executing by the threads or not. So what is that? Is our Java program executing by the threads or not? 100% is yes. Executing by whom? JVM. But internally it will take the support of what here? Thread. That thread name is what? Main thread. Okay. Now observe. If you are writing logic within the static block and non-static block and a static method and non-static method, and if you take constructor, everything will be executing by whom? Main thread only. But what I told you, what is multi-threading? Executing multiple subtasks of a main task. So multiple subtasks executing by multiple threads. But here, whatever the task, whatever the logic we have in program, everything will be executing by whom here? Main thread only. Then how can we introduce the concept like multi-threading? And how can we run our applications by using our own threads? That we will see in next video. I hope you enjoy this video. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh Reddy channel. Thank you.